This week, President Obama announced plans to help more borrowers refinance their upside-down home loans. Here to talk about that is Catherine Reagor. She's a real estate reporter for the Arizona Republic, and it's always good to have you on. We finally got you on for some pretty encouraging news.
Yes. Why? You know, I had heard rumors and speculation about this, and this is not the loan modification. This is the refinancing where people who have done pretty much everything right, they just owe more than their house is worth because of all the foreclosures and short sales and walkaways and drop in home values. And now they're going to be able to refinance. They're lifting the cap.
The cap was, if it was 125% of home value?
So that meant that, you know, you had to be, just 25% underwater. And our home values have dropped 65%. So that doesn't help a lot of people.
And this is the Home Affordable Refinancing Program updated after it had already been updated once before.
Yes, called HARP. Okay. And they use that acronym, but it's called HARP. And they, when it first came out, it was 105% when he announced it in Mesa, and we were like, that's not going to help anybody. And it went to 125% and some people. But since 2009, when they announced it, home prices have dropped more. So they are lifting the cap. You're 200%, you know, underwater, which some people are.
Yes.
And you qualify Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac loan, which...
Okay, that's a requirement. It has to be insured, backed by Fannie and Freddie?
Yes. And most conforming loans are. If you have a jumbo loan, no, you're not. And the limit for a Freddie Mac or Fannie Mae loan in Metro Phoenix has never been more than $500,000. So if your mortgage is $500,000, you're likely not. But people get confused because their bank, well, Bank of America is my lender. Well, they could have made your loan and you could be sending them your payments, but it is backed by Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. And you can go to makinghomeaffordable.gov and figure that out.
Okay, so let's say you find out you're qualified, if you're underwater, you say, hey, this, what exactly do you get? What happens? How does it work?
Well, that we don't have all the details yet. They say December, though. And so that's soon, and that's quick. And they already have the program in place. And, you know, taxpayers, the government owns Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. So this is something they should easily be able to administer through HUD and Treasury. But then essentially, you don't have to get an appraisal, they're saying, because that's a cost. You usually have to pay for a refinancing. And they've streamlined the process. And also, they're going to try to make it competitive with different lenders because they're cutting the fees for lenders. And again, these are mostly conforming loans. These are loans where people are paying on them. So these are loans lenders should want to refinance and keep.
I want to ask you about that because this is, the lenders are going to have to cooperate here. Mm-hmm. Are they going to cooperate here? The president says that if they don't cooperate, this makes for competition for those who want to come in. Well, that's a nice theory. Is it going to work?
You know, we heard that before. Remember when it was first announced, it was the carrot and the stick. It didn't work. The loan modifications did not work. Now, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac are owned by the government. They can push it through. They have the power. And it's working with the lenders. And again, these are the loans they want. These are the loans people are making payments on. So to get it, if you know, otherwise, you know, people are walking away from 7%, 6%. So even if you're making 3.9% or 4% on a mortgage right now, if you're a lender, that's a great return on your money. So we'll see. But they have to carry a big stick. The government, the Obama administration really has to bring that out.
And the idea, of course, being that once you get this refinance, once that albatross is at least lifted a little bit over your head or on your neck or wherever albatrosses are, you have the money to go inject into the economy.
Yes, yes. And you have more money to spend because you could spend, you know, say $500, $1,000 a month. And now the problem is it's not cutting principal. You're still underwater on your mortgage.
Well, yes.
But right now, I mean, if you can't sell anyway, you love your home or like your home, you're in a good neighborhood, a good school, a good shopping center, close to your job, and you can cut your payment by $500 a month, and it costs you very little and doesn't take a lot of time, it seems, you know.
And you mentioned earlier previous government programs, previous plans. This particular program earlier didn't seem to hit a lot of folks in Arizona.
No.
This one seems like this could be a bit of a game changer if everyone cooperates.
Yes. You know, the problem is in the big questions, we did a live chat on this, people have rental homes. It has to be your primary house. You have to live there. And what's sad is some people couldn't make their mortgage payments anymore, so they moved out and now are renting them. So it's sad that that is still their primary. But, you know, the Obama administration is going to have to consider all these factors because the market has changed so much. And if you have a second mortgage, They're kind of blurry on whether you still qualify, but they're going to have to look at that because so many people do.
And skeptics will say another government program. It's yes. simply not going to work. Are you hearing that?
Yes, and we're hearing. But, you know, the money's out there. They didn't spend it mm-hmm. on HAMP, and they didn't spend on the modifications. The money is out there, and they're going to lose it. Yes. But this rewards the people who have done everything right and helps encourage people to stay in their homes instead of walking away because they owe too much. I mean, they owe more than their mortgage. And it could be a good thing. It could be a really good thing for Arizona and help slow foreclosures and stabilize home values.
And so again, no jumbo. You can't have missed more than one payment in the last year.
Yes.
And if you're upside down, good news for you.
Yes, here's when it's good news.
Hope there's a Fannie and Freddie in your yes. portfolio somewhere
and
as well.
And you can check that out. You'll be surprised if it. They own most of the loans out there.
How do you check that out?
That makinghomeaffordable.gov is the government website, and you go through that. You can call your lender and figure it out. There are several ways to do it. If you're confused, email me at catherine.reagor@arizonarepublic.com, and I'll help you.
All right. It's good to have you on your show. We got you on for some good news for a change.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thanks.